Hi and welcome back. In this video, we're going to go ahead and set up the form on the reservations page. And you can see the page here that I have open, and you're going to need to go ahead and create a page in this site just simply by right-clicking up here and selecting New File, and then applying the right-hand sidebar template to that page. And you should come to something roughly that looks like this. And I deleted some of the text that's on here. And this open space is going to be where I'm going to go ahead and place the form. So I'm going to go ahead now and go into Code View. And let's take a look. And you can see here, I actually need to tab that over just a little bit. And it's this empty paragraph tag. That's where I want to go ahead and place the form. So I'm just going to go ahead and delete that and just leave a large open space in here for me to copy and paste the form into. Now I'm going to go ahead and go back into my framework. So I'm going to select that, and inside of the main framework folder you're going to see the forms folder, and we're going to go ahead and grab the code out of the appointment form right here. And if I double click on that to open that up, you'll see if I go into design view roughly the fields that are going to be here. We're going to have a name, an email field, and a phone field, as well as drop downs for the date, a field to enter the time in, and then a message field there, and then finally a submit button. So what we need to do is we need to go into code view for this form, and we need to go ahead and select it. And what we want to do is we want to select everything here from line 33, the opening form tag, all the way down to line 108, the closing form tag. And the easiest way to do that is just to click the first line, scroll down, hold the shift key down on your keyboard, and click on the last line. It'll highlight all of that information for you there. Now I'm going to go ahead and copy that. So I've gone ahead and selected that form, copied the code, and now I'm going to go into reservations, and again, this is the line that I want that form to appear on. So I'm just going to go ahead and highlight it and paste that into place. And we should now see our form on our page. And let's go ahead and save that and go into design view, and we'll go ahead and even look at this in live view right now, and we'll see the way this looks. Not exactly formatted the way we want it to look right now, but that's simply a matter of copying the CSS over so that it works. So I'm going to go ahead and come back into my appointment.html page, and you're going to see up here in the related files we have forms.css. And this file is actually located here in the CSS folder, and it's right there. But you can get to it very easily just by clicking on the related files. And what we want to do is we want to copy all of this code. So I'm going to go ahead and highlight all of the styles that are in here. Everything from the form OL style all the way down to the clear style. And then I'm going to go ahead and copy that. Go back into my reservations, and I'm going to go into my styles.css. And I'm going to go into code view and scroll down. And you're going to find after the containers and the navigation, you'll see the form section right here. And what we want to do is we want to delete everything in here. All the default styles we want to go ahead and delete. So I'm just going to go ahead and highlight those and delete them. And then I'm going to paste the CSS styles in from the framework and save that. And let's go ahead and check out our form now and see how it looks. I'm going to go back into my source code and go into design view. And now your form should look a little bit more like what we saw in the example. And you'll see the drop downs there for the day and the month, as well as the time. The time doesn't have a drop down, they just enter that on in, and the message. And if we wanted to go ahead and modify any of these labels, we could very easily. So I'm going to go ahead and go out of live view here, and name, email, and phone are fine. Please enter the reservation date. I'm going to go ahead and just click right in there and type in the. And then time is fine and message. I'm going to go ahead and change that from message to special instructions. But you could go ahead and make that whatever you want it to be. And then we'll go ahead and save it. And again, look at this in live view. I'm going to close that properties panel. And you remember you can open and close the properties panel just by double clicking on that tab there. And we'll see the way that form is going to look. And as always, we always want to go ahead and preview that in some browsers to see how it's going to look. So let's go ahead and preview this in Chrome and see how it looks. And there we go. There's our form. And you'll see the drop downs and the way they work, as well as the submit button. We have to come back and revisit that in just a second. And let's try one other browser. Let's try an Internet Explorer here. And again, depending on your security settings, you may get this message down here, or there may be a yellow strip up here at the top asking you for permission to show the block content. And that's basically just the JavaScript that's on this page. So I'm going to say allow, and there is my form with my working drop-down list there. And you could try it also in Firefox, Opera, Safari, but it's going to look just great here. Now, when you submit the form, an action is performed, and whatever file is specified in the action property for the form, that's going to be the file that actually runs. And if we go ahead and come back in here to code view and scroll to the point where we can see the top of the form, you're going to see right here we have method post. We don't have an action. I'm sorry, we do have action right there. And you're going to see it says enter processor script right there. You need some sort of a script that will actually convert the contents of this form into an email so you can actually receive it. Now, there are lots of different form to email scripts that are out there. I have one that I include in my framework. Some web hosts require that you use their particular script. So if the script that I give you doesn't work, be sure to check with your web host and see what exactly their requirements are. If they require you to use their script, or possibly if they need to enable form to email on your server. But either way, you are going to need to put in the path to a form processing script in here. So I'm going to go ahead here, and I'm in my framework right now. And you're going to see there's a PHP folder right here. And there's mail form. I'm going to go ahead and right click on that, edit and copy. And that's the file that I need. That's the mail form processing script. And I'm going to go ahead and go back into my project. And there's my PHP folder. I'm simply going to right click, edit, and paste that in there. And I actually already had that in there, so I'm just going to hit yes to all there. But that mail form needs to be in the PHP folder. You then need to go ahead and come back here to the first line in your form, highlight this value right there, including the quotation marks, type a quotation mark, and again, that brings up Dreamweaver's browse command. I'll hit enter, and I'm in my select file dialog box. You want to make sure that you're in your local root folder here, and there is a PHP folder. Let's go ahead and double click on that. I'm going to select that and click OK. And you'll see the path that form has been placed in there. Now, this is a PHP script. And the vast majority of web servers that people use are going to be Linux servers that are going to have PHP running on them. So this script will work, provided your web host allows form to email scripts to run. If you're on a Windows server, you're going to need to find a Windows ASP or ASP.NET script to process your email. And again, your web host may have one already for you. Now I'm going to go ahead and I need to do one more thing here. I'm going to go ahead and double click to open this mailform.php up. And if you're in design view, you're not going to see anything at all. We need to be in code view for this. And you're going to see there's a few different options that you need to set here. The first option that you need to enter in is your email address, or the email address that you want the form to be sent to. So you'll go ahead and modify that. Your website here, you need to put in the full URL for your website. So if your website is http://www.conterestaurant.info, you would go ahead and enter that in there, including the HTTP. Now, when somebody successfully submits the form, it's going to take them to a thank you page. And if you want to enter that in, again, you can go ahead and enter that value in right here. And again, that can be any page at all. It can be a confirmation window, a thank you page, could be the home page of your website. But you need to go ahead and enter some sort of a page for the person to be taken to when they actually finish submitting the form. So I'm going to go ahead and come in here to Files, and again, I'm in my video project file here. I'm going to create a new file, and I'm going to call it thankyou.html. I'm going to go ahead and open that on up, and right now it's blank, so I'm going to go to Modify, Templates, Apply Template to Page, and I'm going to select the template that I want to use. And then I'm just going to go ahead and say thank you here. And then you could put whatever other information you want into this form. And I'm going to go ahead and save it. Close it. And again, right here, that's where you need to go ahead and put the URL to the thank you page. And since the thank you page in this case is in the same directory as the reservations page, all I need to do is type in the name of the page right there, thankyou.html. So I'm going to go ahead and save that. And that's all you need to do to set up your reservation form. And again, if when you click submit here, if you've gone through this and set all the settings correct, you should get an email shortly with the contents that you entered into the form. If you don't get an email, go back and check and make sure you've set everything up correctly, that you've copied and pasted everything over, that everything's in the proper location. If things still don't work, there's probably a problem somewhere on the server. So you're going to need to contact your web host and talk to them about what they allow as far as forms on their server. They may need to enable form to email, or they may have a specific script that you need to include on your page in order for that to work. So that's all you have to do to set up the reservations page on your sample site. I'll see you in the next video.